feed the true Lent. Is this a fast to keep the Lord a lean and clean from fat and fields of sheep? Is it to quit the dish of flesh, yet still to fill the platter high with fish? Is it to fast an hour, or ragged to go, or show an outcast look and sour? No, 'tis to fast to dole thy sheaf of wheat and meat unto the hungry soul. It is to fast from strife, from old debate and hate, to circumcise thy life, to show our heart grief rent, to start thy sin, not bin, and that's to keep thy Lent. The Lord be with you, and also with you. We say together our opening prayer. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you, and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, the first commandment is this: Hear, Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: Love your neighbour as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Having heard our Lord's commands, let us pause, examine our hearts, and seek his forgiveness. Wash me thoroughly from my wickedness, and cleanse me from my sin. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Make me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, forgive all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, because we are in the season of Lent, in place of the Gloria in Excelsis, which we've been using up to now, we're going to say together the canticle, Saviour of the World. Jesus, Saviour of the world, come to us in your mercy. We look to you to save and help us. By your cross and your life laid down, you set your people free. We look to you to save and help us. When they were ready to perish,
reading from the book of Genesis. Then God said to Noah and to his sons with him, "As for me, I am establishing my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that is with you, the birds, the domestic animals, and every animal of the earth with you, as many as came out of the ark. I establish my covenant with you, that never again shall all flesh be cut off by the waters of a flood, and never again shall there be a flood to destroy the earth." God said, "This is the sign of the covenant that I make between you and me and every living creature that is with you for all future generations. I have set my bow in the clouds, and it shall be a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth and the bow is seen in the clouds, I will remember my covenant that is between me and you and every living creature of all flesh. And the waters shall never again become a flood to destroy all flesh. When the bow is in the clouds, I will see it and remember the everlasting covenant between God and every living creature of all flesh that is on the earth." God said to Noah, "This is the sign of the covenant that I have established between me and all flesh that is on the earth." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Today we use our responsorial psalm, part of Psalm 25. The response is, "Remember, Lord, your compassion and love." And I shall bow to indicate when the response comes. "Remember, Lord, your compassion and love." To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. O Lord, in you, O my God, into you I trust. Let me not be put to shame. Let not my enemies triumph over me. Let none who look to you be put to shame, but let the treacherous be shamed and frustrated. Make me know your ways, O Lord, and teach me your paths. Lead me in your truth and teach me, for you are the God of my salvation. For you have I hoped all the day long. Remember, Lord, your compassion and love, for they are from everlasting. Remember, Lord, your compassion and love. Remember not the sins of my youth or my transgressions, but think on me in your goodness, O Lord, according to your steadfast love. Gracious and upright is the Lord. Therefore shall he teach sinners in the way. He will guide the humble in doing right and teach his way to the lowly. All the paths of the Lord are mercy and truth to those who keep his covenant and his testimonies. Remember, Lord, your compassion and love. We hear our gospel reading.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. And just as he was coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens torn apart and the Spirit descending like a dove on him. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." And the Spirit immediately drove him out into the wilderness. He was in the wilderness for 40 days, tempted by Satan. And he was with the wild beasts. and the angels waited on him. Now after John was arrested, Jesus came to Galilee, proclaiming the good news of God and saying, "The time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
May I speak in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Well, can you believe it? We are in Lent again. The wonder and joy of Christmas and Epiphany is over, and it has quickly moved on to a more sober, reflective time. And in terms of the seasons in the nature around us, the grey and cold of winter, in many ways it can seem to coincide. The need to hunker down and stay in more than usual. But then, with this last 12 months, you could say that's nothing new. For many, Lent is penitential, when we traditionally give something up for Lent. Things that maybe we have too much of, used to excess, or come to rely on to keep going, that actually aren't necessary or essential. It is a way to reflect and refocus on how we live, our priorities in life, where we are at. A bit like the traditional spring clean of the house, in the cupboards and pantry, finding the food or tins that we've forgotten about, that we can actually use. Or maybe I've actually passed its use-by date. You know the kind of thing. Getting back in order, on track, whatever you call it. It's a time for looking forward, to be honest about where we are now, and where appropriate, to move on in a new state. Our journey. Both of the readings today have an element of that. Noah, having trusted God, endured ridicule for building the ark, the dealing with the time in the ark, surviving the devastation, coming out safely onto dry land to new creation by the grace of God. Being given a rainbow as a sign of hope, a promise of God, new life, renewed by the grace of God. Then we have the baptism of Jesus, a new and important phase in his life on earth. After 30 years, loving obedience with his family, here is a commitment, the dedication and anointing to the next stage, his ministry. It's almost a leaving behind and moving onwards, despite knowing where it would lead. An affirmation of his identity by God and the Holy Spirit, and the consequent working out of that reality in the wilderness. Being alone and vulnerable. Seeing what that means. Obedience. Service. Love. Speaking truth and life. Sacrifice. glamour, fame, might, power and majesty, as some would have expected. So then, how does that relate to us in 2021? Nearly a year on into a pandemic, which has left many frustrated, anxious, fearful, questioning, isolated, their world turned upside down in lots of ways. You could say it's been like a wilderness experience, or being in the ark, not knowing when things will end. It isn't easy, to say the least. Yet, we have a positive opportunity for some space and time to reflect without some of the distractions and props that we may usually have, or the masks that we have put on over time. Maybe with the help of one of the Lent options we've suggested in church here, or reading a Bible, religious book, or just having quiet time and space to rebuild our relationship with God. Letting the message of love and hope in God's love for each of us take a deeper and stronger root in our lives. Being open to the freedom, transforming life and love of God. Could be making positive decisions about what we do, how we live our lives, trusting in the promise and grace of God. A positive renewal of our faith, our focus. And it's the same that applies to our church, our activities and worship. It's something that the diocese been asking each of our churches to do. At Easter, the end of Lent, traditionally there is a renewal of our baptismal vows each Sunday. In the service we affirm our belief in the Creed, our relationship with God, and therefore each other. May we, this Lent, experience it as a time when we realise again, afresh, refocus, refresh and renew our relationship and walk with God, and our move onwards in our journey with Him, wherever that may lead us. I'd like to end the prayer that is in the Northumberland community and one that is used by the Scarborough community as a blessing whenever they hold any of their courses, and they still use it online now. May the peace of the Lord Christ go with you, wherever He may send you. May He guide you through the wilderness, protect you through the storm. May He bring you home rejoicing at the wonders He has shown you. May He bring you home rejoicing once again into our doors. Amen.
Sunday, let us affirm our relationship with God, with all our fellow Christians of every tradition. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world? We believe and trust in him. This is the faith of the Church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So we come to our prayers for intercession.
Father, this time of Lent, we thank you that we are known and loved by you. May we this Lent realize that and hold on to that promise. So we consider your greatness and our own weakness. Help us to be open to your loving presence and guidance now and for the future. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
That this time when we are called to pray for our nation and the world, a prayer from the call to prayer for this week of the Church of England. Loving Father God, be with us in our distress. Be with our families, friends and neighbours, our country and our world. Give health to the sick, hope to the fearful, and comfort to the mourners. Give wisdom to our frontline and key workers, insight to our government, and patience to us all. Overcome disease with the power of your new life, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear.
Yeah.
We pray for our own diocese here at Blackburn, for our bishops Julian, Philip and Jill, for their wisdom and guidance at this time, for our church here of St. Thomas, for our vicar Chris, for our ministry team and church wardens and PCC, as we seek your way forward for our church. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our school as they wait to hear the way forward for its full reopening. We ask your blessing and guidance on all the staff and governors as they work through all that is required. And we we pray, the pupils and families, as they seek and prepare to come back to school. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Following our weekly prayer diary, we include in our prayers those who live in Lindsay Avenue and Haymarket. And we ask for your blessing on our scouts, cubs and beavers at this difficult time for them. And we bring before your loving care, O Lord, those who are sick, in body, mind or spirit. May they know your presence and blessing and comfort. We particularly pray for Eileen Petridge, Janet Bianchini, Julie Belkett, Doreen Croysdale, Nicola Cunningham, Fran Davis, Frances Dugdale, Judith Eastwood, Marion Fielding, Jesse Hitch, Gloria and John Gibson, Jane Greenhouse, Martin Greer, John Hare, Anne Hewlett, Shirley Jackson, Eileen McGuckin, John McGuckin, June Medlicott, Hilary Myers, Sylvia Nicholas, Heather Pascoe, Anthony Rayner, Pat Rayner, Catherine Roberts, Roy Simpson, June Thompson, Sarah, Baby Izzy. And we name in our hearts before you, Lord, those close to us and known to us in need. May they know your healing presence with them, O Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear. Yeah. Died recently. Lee Greenfield, Alan Hodge, Dennis Burdon Burry. May they rest in peace. May you bring your comfort and love to all those friends and family who grieve. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Prayer for today, this week, a comment. Almighty God, whose Son Jesus Christ fasted 40 days in the wilderness and was tempted as we are, yet without sin, give us grace to discipline ourselves in obedience to your Spirit. And as you know our weakness, so may we know your power to save. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Bring all our prayers together he himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. The peace of the Lord be always with you, and also with you. Let's offer one another a sign of peace. Peace be with you. God, who from the death of sin raised you to new life in Christ, keep you from falling and set you in the presence of his glory and the blessing.